I'm going to say a lot of things that may bother some of you, but please be patient. I'm not your enemy. I'm going to tell you things that about your society that you may or may not know. These people in government, what is a politician? I don't want you to take my word. I want you to walk over to any politician you know or do not know and ask them, how can you grow food faster without exhausting the soil and feed the hungry? I don't know. How can you make automobiles that don't hit each other? I don't know. How can you make highways safer? I don't know. They don't know anything. Don't take my word for it. Ask them. The people in Washington, I can only talk about them. I believe all countries are similar. The people in Washington should know more about human behavior, the latest technologies. They tell you if you want freedom, write your congressman. Why do you have to write him? He should know all those things. When you fly in an airplane, you don't have to write the pilot. Say you've been flying at an angle for half an hour, straighten up. They know their business. No politician has ever increased the agricultural yield, made automobiles safer, airplanes safer. What the hell are they doing there? How do they get the job? There's something dreadfully wrong with education. All countries, all, are basically corrupt. If you don't understand what I'm saying, where do you think America got America from? You think the Indians said, come on over, enjoy yourself, take all the land you want? No, we killed thousands of Indians. We starved 50 million buffalo to make it tough for the Indians. And the Indians that fought back really tried to take some land back, but the government decided that they wanted to get rid of those aggressive Indians that wouldn't conform to what we wanted. So they offered 10 bucks for every Indian you killed. And the guy walked over and he said, I just killed 10 Indians. The government said, how do we know that? Bring back a piece of the Indian. They started scalping Americans, not the Indians. And we brought back 10 scalps to collect 10 bucks for every Indian you killed. Americans are no good, the French are no good, the Greeks are no good. All nations are corrupt. They say the sun never sets on England. Where do you think England got all that land from? They took it by killing thousands of people. Patriotism, Einstein said, is a disease. But he couldn't say that publicly. When he came to this country, he was a socialist to America. And they said, don't talk socialism, they'll ship your ass back to Germany. The United States Army dumped 65 tons of nerve gas into the ocean off the coast of Miami, near the Gulf Stream. How can you love the country if the Army did that? They don't know what they're doing. They say, we want you to dump nerve gas. Yes, sir. We don't want obedient people anymore. We want you to understand what's happening. When you're born in a polluted world with smog in the air and automobile pollution, you say, I guess that's the way it is. It isn't that way. It's because the people in charge of government are totally incompetent. So what you really want is a world free. Free of burden, pain, prisons, police, crime. All of us need security. All people all over the world need clean air, clean water, arable land, and a relevant education. What does relevant education mean? To study agriculture, nature, how we relate to nature, how we relate to one another, to give us the tools to live in accordance with what we want, not what they want you to be. They want you to be patriotic. That means they want to control you. Whenever you do anything new or different, instead of people saying, you know, that's an interesting thing, let me think about it, you know, they get mad at you because you're upsetting the apple cart. And that's what it's about. We have a tough job ahead. All of us. If you wish to live in a world without war, poverty, unemployment, hunger, human suffering, you have to talk to other people. If you do nothing, I can assure you, nothing will happen.